TFNN. Headline news update.
Welcome, everybody. Tommy O'Brien coming to you live from TFNN headquarters in Clearwater, Florida. It's Monday. It's 9 a.m., 30 minutes until that opening bell. Let's check in on the markets as all major indices currently higher. Looking at Dow futures up 38 points, trading at 24,374. S&P positive by 1, trading at 26.55, and NASDAQ futures positive by 7 points, trading at 63.65. Let's start things off, jump over to the VIX. VIX, as this market just keeps creeping higher. Last week, we finished it off on a positive note. This morning, 9.93 on that VIX number. Low volatility in the market as it continues higher. Let's jump over to the Nadex platform, check in on some of the futures markets. With 30 minutes until that opening bell, S&P 500. So what we do have this morning going on that played into the market somewhat around the futures was there was a explosion in a Manhattan subway, by Times Square. And it looks to be a pipe bomb. They have one person in custody, and maybe that person was the person with the bomb. Non-life-threatening injury. They're hurt, though. But that seems to be what the S&Ps were higher. NASDAQ was higher. So you had that pulling back a little bit on those first reports and then kind of rebounding as more details come out. S&P trading 26.55. NASDAQ 100, similar volatility, inching back up, trading 63.66. Dow 30, 24,377. You can see kind of that initial decline on those reports. Going over to currency market, seeing a little bit of dollar strength. Euro weakness, euro 117.80 currently. Gold, again, kind of right around 8 o'clock was that news. Not sure if it's factoring into the gold market, but pulling back under 1250. Gold, looking at the February contract, 1249.25. And crude oil trading 57.46. Okay, what else? Sunday night, and there is the reports they had. Sunday night, we have Bitcoin futures surging as they debut in the futures market. So the price of Bitcoin up more than 26% at one point, causing two different trading halts. The notional value of all the Bitcoin that was traded was only about $40 or $50 million, compared to about $1 billion on the global market of Bitcoin. But either way, there was worries that you could see some dramatic selling pushing the price downwards. What's new with Bitcoin? That's not the case. Upward they go. All right, stay tuned. We have our man, Larry Pesavento, coming up right here at 9 o'clock. I'll be back at 10 with Tom. Then, of course, swim lessons. Basil Chapman at 12, Steve Rhodes at 1, Dave White at 2, Tom O'Brien at 3 o'clock. Have a great day. I'll talk to you next hour.